we pop out at your party. I'm with the gang, and it's gonna be a robbery. So tuck your chain, I'm a killer, girl, I'm sorry. But I can't change, we ain't aiming for your body. Shots hit your brain. We come from poverty, man, we ain't have a thing. It's a lot of animosity, but they won't say my name.
Time to get down to the nitty gritty. Time to get down to the nitty gritty. Gonna figure this out. Welcome today, ladies and gentlemen. I am the host, Jimmy Red Pill. Welcome to my show, Red Pill Blog Talk. Okay. God damn. I just drove by Memphis Creek. I can't believe motherfuckers fishing these little lakes and creeks in Memphis. I wouldn't eat no fish out of this motherfucker. Out of them nasty ass creeks. They suffered to find a dead body in one of these goddamn lakes and creeks here in Memphis. Just seen a motherfucker over there fishing. Fishing crappies or some shit, catfish. Anyway, gloomy day here in Memphis. It's kind of gloomy. Not too sunny today. Gonna make it do what it do. Okay. Enough of the small talk. Well, I did it again, y'all. I forgot to bring the cut the bitch water off t-shirts in the car. But the last video y'all saw. Cut the bitch water off t-shirts. I got them. They're available. They're hot off the press. Send me $30. They're really $25. I'm going to go $30. Extra $5 for shipping and handling. But $30. Send me $30 to Money Symbol Gunslinger 38111 on the Cash App. Put your address in the footnotes. Red Pill Blog Talk t-shirts. Send me $30, Money Symbol, Gunslinger 38111 on the Cash App. Or if you want to just support the channel, you want to support the channel, send me money to Money Symbol, Gunslinger 38111 on Cash App. Just want to just support the channel. We not financing this channel through fucking bubblegum rappers, okay? I'm asking y'all for money. Joe Biden, just take your money. President Joe Biden, just take your money. And don't ask for it. At least I'm asking for it. I'm working on getting a super chat set up for my live streams. The show is growing. I got nephews. Brothers who are good at all that computer technology who won't help me. But oh well. I got my own empire. I pulled myself up by my bootstraps and I figured out on my own about all the technology to make the show better. To my fans, the show is going to have some improvements shortly. Okay, we're through with the 5-minute monologue. Okay, today's topic about the 3 shot in Memphis. 3 people shot in Memphis. 1 mom and 3 shot here in Memphis. I believe that's the correct title. Correct me in the comments. It's went nationwide. A lot of bloggers are talking about it. I'm going to have a clip of the video. I'm going to try to have a clip of the video in the show. But basically, what happened here in Memphis last week was a guy and his daughters drove to four young teenagers' house, some females' house, about some kind of Facebook beef.
Oh.
Something about somebody doing something to my car or something to that effect. And it was a female, what they call Tam Tam, and her daughter's house that the guy brought his daughters to her house. And it was supposed to be for a one-on-one. But some of Tam Tam daughter friends jumped in, started helping, jumping her. Daughter. So the father stepped in. Intervened, and when he intervened, allegedly, this is all allegedly, allegedly, the mother pulled out a gun. Well, it's on video. I don't know how much alleged I can, but we just gonna say alleged, y'all. It's all on live stream, YouTube live, but I mean Facebook live. The mother pulls out her gun. And when the mother, when supposedly Tam Tam pulled out her gun, the father of the female that she was fighting with, went back to his partner car. And the partner allegedly gave him a gun. And he came up and he popped him. So, I mean, first of all, this Memphis, everybody got guns. I'm telling y'all, this audience, Memphis is crazy. Memphis got lax gun laws. You can be 18 year old and go buy a Draco in Memphis. With them baby AK-47s, you don't have to be 18 to buy that. You don't need no gun permit. You can literally buy a gun and put that motherfucker on your hip, walk down the street. Actually, you can walk down the street with an AR pointed in the air. If it's pointed in the air, it's legal. Wouldn't recommend it, especially if you're black. The police gonna be like, get out, get your ass on the ground. Get on the ground, your ass gonna be like a damn robot.
Oh.
Wouldn't recommend that, but technically by law you could do it. It's been done, a white boy did it, but he did that shit before the police came. Did that before the police came up with their own to him, so. Basically, like the old saying goes, pull that pistol, you better use it. I mean, the female, the Tam Tam, found out she played a deadly game, and she found out the hard way. You pull that pistol out, you better use it. I'm armed security guard, and I work for one company, and they told us, you only pull that pistol out for two reasons. To clean it and to use it. So, first mistake she made. Got to go in the store, get me some refreshments, be right back.
YouTube, this is fair use. Fair use. YouTube, this is fair use for educational purposes only.
A mother sadly is dead and three other people wounded after a shooting in South Memphis. Memphis police saying a street fight among children ended with gunshots and everything was captured on camera. Good evening, and thank you for joining us. I'm Greg Hirsch.
Lots of chaos there. I'm Stephanie Scurlock. WREG's Quamitra Wilburn spoke to witnesses who say this could have all been avoided. It's an encounter that has left people in this South Memphis community heartbroken. Video shared with WREG shows a man shooting and killing a woman following a massive street fight. Court documents identify the victim as Tamara Plummer. Close friends say she died protecting her children. MPD says the shooting happened on Quinn Avenue Thursday evening. Angela Hinton says Plummer, whom she affectionately calls Tammy, is her godniece.
She was always happy when she come around me.
The video starts with Plummer, seen in green, talking to two men. The adults are surrounded by rowdy teenagers. A witness and close friend says the men walked to Plummer's home with their children in an attempt to fight Plummer's children. Suddenly, a teen lashes out at another and a brawl breaks out. We've blurred much of the video since it's believed majority of the people involved are minors. You can see Plummer armed with a gun and the men attempt to break up the fight. After several grueling seconds, the witness tells WREG Plummer raised her weapon intending to end the fight. However, before Plummer could shoot in the air, this man walks toward her and fatally shoots her.
She loved to do her hair, but I ain't never known her being no violent person.
MPD identifies the man as Jayon Davis. In another video shared on social media, a woman can be seen shooting Davis as he walks away after shooting Plummer. Police say she's Plummer's daughter, 20-year-old Destiny Plummer. Another woman and a juvenile were also hit. Close friends say Plummer was a dedicated mother who did everything she could to protect her children.
Every time you look around, she's doing everything for her kids, supporting. And I love the way she bring them up, the way she talk to them, communicating, and she stay focused on them all the time.
Destiny Plummer is charged with reckless endangerment, while Davis faces a first-degree murder charge. Reporting from South Memphis, Quamitra Wilburn, WREG, News Channel 3.
We back to the show. Okay. Like I say, you know, it was that was the first mistake. And two, I mean, when would niggas learn? I mean, this Memphis. I mean, you, like I say all the time, y'all, you put your hands on somebody, respectful, it can go to 0 to 100. Also, I think the Tam Tam Kip folks was wrong because they should have made sure it should have been 1-on-1. Ain't no jumping. I agree with the problem. Hey, ain't no jumping. Ain't no, you know. Fuck that. And you know, I mean, I don't blame the father. I mean, like, shit, who wanna sit there and watch their daughter get jumped and not do nothing? Shit, he manned up. I mean, he got an attempted murder charge. He got a murder charge, attempted murder charge. No, not murder, there, murder charge. He got a murder charge. I doubt that first degree is not gonna stick. He might get it. I don't know if he gonna beat it, but I know he can get him dropped down to manslaughter. He might get that broke down to manslaughter for when he was defending his daughter. And the female, Tam Tam, did have a gun. So, or he might beat it. It's a statement. Well, he went back to the car. I don't think he gonna take something because you can't say, if we had the gun on him, well, she didn't point the gun at him either. If she would have pointed the gun at him and he had the gun on him, he could have beat it. Stand your ground law. Tennessee has a stand your ground law. Right now, he might have to take a charge. He might have to. But if he got a good lawyer, he'd probably get it broke down to just manslaughter. And manslaughter, that may be about like 3 years or something. You know. That was the thing. He should have had the gun on him. You know, oh yeah, another thing messed him up, he's a felon. That was another thing. He's a felon with a firearm. So oh yeah, you had to do that 10. You gotta do 10 on top of that. That was the third mistake. He seen going back to the car. Two convicted felon. So that part he may have to take something, you know. But, you know, emotions fly. I mean, it is what it is. You know, some fellas about that life, especially when it come to their kids. I got a couple of guy friends, man. They go all out for their daughter. Their daughter? You know, the son, too, but they really gonna go all out for their daughter. So, and most, like you say, most fathers not gonna sit back and see their daughter get jumped. So, I mean, it is what it is. But my point of this video, I mean, well, he shouldn't have brought them to their house like that. And he shouldn't have brought his daughter and friends to the Lady Tam Tam house. I wouldn't have did that. Supposed to catch you in the bathroom in high school or something, catch you at the bathroom, catch you out and about by herself or something like that, or with, you know, he should have picked out a better place to try to get his one on, try to have his daughter get that one on one. That's what I feel. But the moral of the story is, Memphis, shit, like I said, everybody got guns. R.I.P. To Miss Tam Tam. R.I.P. But the moral of the story is, you know, when you get into it with somebody in Memphis, you know, it can go left field. You know, expect the worst. Remember, fellas, I mean, remember everybody. You know, this Memphis, everybody got guns. Memphis got legs. Just Memphis people, they just gonna have to, you know, coexist. Gonna have to get along. Y'all gonna have to figure this shit out. You know, stop the violence. Well, I can say stop the violence, but, you know, I'm from the Beltland Orange Mound. You know, ain't gonna be no violence without violence. You know, that was our motto. Ain't gonna be no violence without violence. So, you know, you kill my dog, we gonna slay your cat. You know, so it's at the same time. So, but just brothers and sisters, just be careful. Put your hands on somebody. Remember, you can go to 0 to 100. Also, if you got a pistol, you pull out a pistol. Use that motherfucker. That's my advice. And try to get along, y'all. You know, try to coexist. Try to respect one another. And that's the only thing I can say. But like, share, and subscribe. But in the words of Elvis Presley, thank y'all very much.